knows where that is.
Lucky. So the White House is pushing back against claims by the architect of Obamacare that a lack of transparency and that combined with, you know, the stupidity of the American people was key to getting the whole thing passed. They're insisting, though, that the bill was transparent, the White House is. This after the MIT professor, Jonathan Gruber, who's now a well-known name across the country, was caught not once, not twice, but now it turns out three different times. I wonder how many more tapes there might be out there. Insulting voters while explaining the ulterior motives behind his strategy. Congressman Aaron Schock telling Greta Van Susteren that it is not the first time that Democrats have talked down to Americans while defending Obamacare. Watch.
It was the then Speaker of the House who told the American people, we're just going to have to find out, we're just going to have to pass it before we find out what's in the bill. I mean, how much more of a talk down to the American people can that be? And now you see the architect of the bill say that we don't trust the American people enough to figure this out on their own. You ask yourself why the American people doesn't trust government? It's because the government doesn't trust the hardworking taxpayers.
Leslie Marshall, syndicated radio talk show host and Fox News contributor, and Kevin Jackson is founder of the Black Sphere. Welcome to both of you. Leslie, this guy just keeps digging the hole deeper and deeper, and it doesn't look good for health care.
Well, Martha, I have to tell you, I interviewed Jonathan Gruber just a couple of weeks ago on my talk show, and we went line by line as to the economic benefits. He didn't call anyone stupid, and although I tell my kids that's a very bad word, and I do think it is, the American people aren't stupid. The American voters aren't stupid, and they know that some stupid remarks by a highbrow academic who do speak down to the American people frequently. I'm from Boston. I know this MIT type. Sorry, guys, but you know it's true. The bottom line here is one person's foolish remark that is offensive to the American people and voter does not make a reason for why you should wipe out legislation and take away the health care of thousands and millions of people. When you look at two-thirds of the states in this country that don't have exchanges in the states, if we wipe out the law, who would take the health care benefits away from currently based on one person's stupid remark?
Okay. So, Kevin, what do you think? I mean, is Jonathan Gruber just sort of an ivory tower academic who's speaking for himself, or does he reflect a larger sentiment that seems to be pervasive in the White House on this bill?
It's not only pervasive in the White House, Martha, it's pervasive in the liberal community, period. Look, without the things that happened with Obamacare and the strategy that they put together, Obamacare would have gone over like a pregnant pole vaulter. It was not going to pass. And Gruber knows that. And so do most of America. We all realize that this was a joke. Look, Gruber did this it wasn't one time, Martha. It was multiple times that he said this. And the White House can try to walk it back. Leslie can claim, oh, he's just a highbrow academic. No, what he is he's an economist from MIT. You can't walk that back. He is the architect of this plan. He knew exactly what he was doing. You can't find there's no new doctors, there's no new equipment. Nothing about this Obamacare has benefited the American people unless you are getting a rebate, which is essentially, that's it. There's been nothing about Obamacare.
We're all still picturing the pregnant pole vaulter going over.
Yeah.
And it's probably not pretty. Having been there three times myself, it probably wouldn't be pretty. So, you know, the big question is here, and I want to pull up the cover of this comic book that Jonathan Gruber also put out, which has led a lot of people to say that he's once again, you know, talking down to the American people and dumbing this down into comic book form to help them understand what was going on. And it turns out when you look at the polls that they did understand, Leslie, because 55% of the American people said that they believe that the administration misled when they sold this bill to them and that they weren't clear and that they weren't transparent with them. So the American people, it turns out, are pretty smart after all. But one of the big things that this may have triggered, these Gruber comments, Leslie, is a reinvigorated effort on the GOP's part as they come into power to do whatever they can to repeal this this bill or to reform it.
I don't think they needed the reinvigoration, but certainly Mr. Gruber's comments have helped that. I mean, despite poll after poll showing the American people, regardless of their ideology, that they don't want Obamacare to be repealed or replaced. They do want millions of people who are benefiting. Think about it, people on life support right now who may not be with us if they didn't have insurance. So, and when I was pregnant, no, I wasn't pole vaulting, but to say that, you know, Americans aren't benefiting from this, especially in the states with the exchanges like where I am here in California, California. That's not accurate. I know the people that have insurance that didn't have it before. And when we speak to the economy, lots of people who had insurance that they liked don't have it anymore
and who are paying more for the insurance that they liked. And those are exactly the people that Gruber says are too stupid because the insurance company passed along the cost to them. So we have to leave it there. Thank you both. It's great to have you here. Kevin, we'll get you out here next time with the pregnant pole vaulter because we love that comment so much. We can't wait to have you back. Leslie, thanks to you as well. We'll see you both next time.
Thank you, guys.